Heint Reboisei, etliche Wörter, mekoret der Klatsche. Die Klatsche ist geschrieben auf einem hohen Gang. Auf dem Gang, wie die Alte haben geschrieben. Etliche wird sie verstehen, kifi sein Verstand und sein Madrege. Vermenschlich für eine kleine Madrege wird sie sein Pushet, a wunderschöne Meisse, sie wird glatt gefällt, der proste Pschat. Let's translate. Die Klatsche, that's the work that is called the Klatsche or the Nag, is geschrieben, is written, auf a hohen Gang, in a high style, elaborate style. Auf dem Gang, in such a style, wie die Alte haben geschrieben. In the style of the old ones, the way the old ones used to write, meaning it's an old-fashioned style. Etliche wird sie verstehen, kefi sein Verstand und sein Madrege. Each one, meaning each reader, will understand her, sie, meaning the work, the klatsche is a her, kefi, in accordance, sein Verstand, his understanding, und sein Madrege, and his level. Vermenschlich von a kleine Madrege, for those people of the small level, literally the small level, low level. Wird sie sein pushet a wunderschöne Meisse, sie wird glatt gefällt der proste Pschat. So for people of low level, that's the words that he uses, Mendele, she will appear poshet, simply, a wunderschöne Meisse, a wonderful, fine, beautiful story. Ze wird glatt gefällt der proste Pschat. They will simply like the simple pshat. Pshat is the literal meaning. There are four levels of interpretation of scripture, and pshat is the simplest level of interpretation, meaning literal level. Ze wird glatt gefällt der proste Pshat. We're continuing. Die Dosike aber von einer größeren Madrege werden euch in ihr Gefällen epsa gefinnen, epsa wunk, a remes, a gegen uns sündige Menschen. Let's translate. Die Dosike, those, aber, however, von einer größeren Madrege, the higher level, than the earlier level, weln euch in ihr, will also in her gefinnen find epsa wunk. A wunk is a hint. A remes is the same as a wunk. A remes, remes is allegory in Hebrew, but also a hint. A gegen uns sündige Menschen, in regards to us, in relation a gegen sinful people, sinful humans. So what Mendel is doing here, he's going through four levels of scriptural interpretation. Pshat, remes, he bypasses the third one, which is called drush, And she goes on to the next one, which is called Sod, Secret. Ich hastege, in my madrege, ob ich, ob in ihr gefunden, kemat alle jüdische Neshumas, alle unsere Nefashes, und dem Sod, was they to and do of dem Olam. Let's translate. Ich hastege, as far as I am concerned, for instance, hastege is, for example, for instance, in my madrege, in my level, ob in ihr gefunden kemat alle jiddische neshumas. I found in her almost kemat all Jewish souls. Yiddishe neshumas, alle unsere nefashes, all our nefashes, I believe is beings, nefashes, not nefashes, nefashes, is souls, persons, could be beings, but let's say persons, alle unsere nefashes, in dem sod, undem sod, and the secret, sod, secret, the fourth level of interpretation, the highest, was they to and do of dem olam, that they're doing here in this world. Ich bin bei mir ganz sicher, als bishas lehnen, wel nasach von eich raboisim, itleche in sein Grad, sich nicht kennen einhalten. Einer wird mit Feier agishreitun. Ei, das ist an onzi herrenisch, akegen unser Rebjöisim. Noch einer. Ei, das meint man Nossen Reb Chaikes, Salmen Jekele Reb Moteles, Herrschke Reb Aveles, Adrita, ei, ei, ich hab gefunden dem Sod von unsere Taxes, von unsere Balatoives, und von unsere alle Führungen Ochadoime. Let's translate. Ich bin bei mir ganz sicher, I am entirely confident, as bishas leinen, that during reading, vel nasach von euch, a lot of you will, raboisim, my lords or gentlemen, itlach in sein grad, each one in his level, in his category, grad, Grad is grade or degree, so let's say grade. Each man in his own grade, sich nicht kennen einhalten, you won't be able to contain yourself. Einer wird mit Feuer geschreitun, one will with enthusiasm, with fire, make a scream out, yell out. Ei, das ist an unsere herrenische Kegen, unser Reb Yosin. Ah, this is a hint about our Reb Yossi, meaning a person by the name of Reb Yossi. And this is the work, the what's written in the work, is a hint about this person, Rabbi Yossi. Noch einer, another person. Ei, das meint man nosen Reb Chaikes. No, they mean this other person, nosen Reb Chaikes. Someone else who they know. So each reader will be able to relate it to someone they know. Zalman Yekele Reb Motilis, another person. Zalman, who is the son of Yekele. No, Zalman Yekele, his name is Zalman Yaakov, but call him Zalman Yekele. He is the son of Reb Motile. Hershke Reb Avelis, and another person. So each reader will find a hint, will find somebody that will recognize while reading the story. Adrita, a third one. Ay, ich hab gefunden dem Sod von unserer Taxes. Ha, I found the secret of our local taxes. Von unserer Balatoivis und von unserer alle Thirungen v'chadoime. I found the secret of our benefactors, local benefactors, community benefactors, Balatoivis, und unsere alle Thirungen v'chadoime, and all of our behavior. V'chadoime or u'chadoime means etc. So I should say a couple of words about this word, taxe. So taxe literally means a local tax. Mendele wrote his first work of fiction that he wrote in Yiddish was called Die Taxe, the tax. And this work was a highly satirical work about the local communities at the time, specifically about taxation of the local communities. There was a tax imposed upon the communities by the Tsarist government, and communities, in order to pay this tax, imposed the leaders of the community imposed this tax upon every single Jew who was buying meat. So because eating meat is a mitzvah, to eat meat at least once a week on Shabbos, unless one was in absolute poverty, most of the community were under this tax. Everybody was obligated to pay this tax on kosher meat. So the work, the tax, was, as I mentioned, highly satirical. And now we're going to read more about this work in very short order. However, it's interesting that Mendele mentions here that as far as the references and the hidden hints, it refers not just to private persons, but it also refers to the community tax. So let us continue. Ich hab gefragt a Scheile bei die Glubske Dayonim und bei alle dortige feine Bries in von der gute Knuffie. Azoi wie ich hab dem Eulam zugesucht, a Reus zu geben a zweite Teil von der Taxe und hab dabei nicht gesucht blineder. Bechein ist doch mein Wort schön gleich taki wie a neder. Heint, wie ist der Dien, Rabbeusim? Hab ich sie gefragt. Als ich gebe a Zinderhäus mein Klatsche, ob ich kann mit dir Jäuze sein mein Neder. Let us translate. This is quite complicated. So, ich hab gefragt a Scheile bei die Glubske Dayonim. I asked a Scheile. A Scheile is a question with regard to the Talmudic law. It's not a simple question. It's a question that one must go to a rabbi who can paskin and shilas, who can adjudicate rabbinical questions, rabbinical law. So I asked a question that deserves an explanation in accordance to the rabbinical law. But the glupske dayonim. Dayonim are the rabbinical judges from the city of Glupsk. As mentioned in earlier, Glupsk is the city of fools. And it's also meant here the city called Berdichev, that was one of the largest Jewish cities in the middle of the 19th century in Ukraine, I believe. Und bei alle dortige feine Bries von der gute Knuffie. And I asked this question of all the local feine Bries, the beautiful people, the beautiful creatures. It's a very highly sarcastic expression. Von der gute Knuffie. Gute Knuffie. Knuffie is a company. And Guter is a good company. Gute Knuffie, again, it's a bit of a put down, really. It's quite the contrary, quite the opposite of what it says, the fine company, the good company. It's exactly the contrary. So he's making fun now of the rabbinical judges. Knuffie is a gang or a clique. So I called it a company earlier. So, a gute Knuffie. Azoi wich hob dem oilem zugesucht, a reus zu geben a zweite teil von der Taxi. Given that I had promised the world, the people, the moilem, zugesucht is promised, herauszugeben a zweiten Teil von der Taxe, to publish a second part from der Taxe. And the taxa is italicized here, meaning the taxa, same as taxa earlier that we mentioned, this taxa. This taxa is the name of the work now. The name of the work that Mendele published some years earlier. So Mendele says here that he promised to publish a second part of the taxa, that his earlier work wasn't enough to describe what the situation was in the community. So he made the promise to publish a second part, to write a second part. However, Arois zu geben is to publish rather than to write. Und ich hab dabei nicht gesucht blineder. And while articulating my promise, I didn't say derbai at the same time, bli neder, without making a neder. Neder is an irrevocable promise, an obligation. Here it says neder is an oath. So he literally made an oath because he didn't say without making an oath. Bli neder or bli neder. Bechein, therefore, is doch mein Wort schon gleichtaki wie ein neder. Therefore, my word is exactly take, gleich, exactly take, actually, like a neder, like an oath, revocable oath. Heind is der din. Heint, wie is der din? So here's the question. That was the preamble. That was the introduction to the question. Because when he published the work Klatsche and didn't Sabli Nadav. So what hind? So now the is the din. What is the law? Din, raboisim, meaning rabbinical judges, gentlemen. Aber sei gefragt, I asked them, as er gibat sin da roitz mein klatsche, now that I publish my klatsche, he calls this work his klatsche, ob ich ken mit ihr joitze sein maneder, whether I can with her, with this work, joitze sein mein neder, satisfy my neder, my oath, whether I can satisfy my promise by publishing this work. So what he's saying is, I haven't published the second part to the Taksit like I promised. However, because he mentioned that some of you will find a reference here or a hint of with regard to our local taxes, perhaps with this work I can satisfy my previous oath, irrevocable oath, to publish a second part to the earlier work. It's a rabbinical question. It's really a question whether he can be released from his oath, earlier oath. Ze hebben geklärt, zich nebber gekratzt, en hebben zum Sof azoi gesucht. Jore Mendele, azoi wimmer hebben du der schmeckt areich, atamtses von der Taxe, zenen mirach der Ribe mater neder. Haklatsche azu, die dosike klatsche, Cheshuva lechem is ach gerechend keilu kamaisem gleich virvolt gehalten wort und arroz gegeben achele kasheni dem zweiten teil meha taxe bechein protev metale pitschewkes nishkushe meken mit ihr sehr gut joitze sein. Okay, this is really hard. They haben geklärt. They thought about it. Sich never gekratzt. Then they started scratching themselves. Und haben zum Sof also gesucht. And finally, at the end, they said in such a manner. Jore Mendele. Yes, Reb Mendele, Mr. Mendele, azoi v'merobn du der schmeckt areich, given that we have sensed, literally der schmeckt is smelled, areich, a smell, a scent. We have smelled a scent, sensed a scent, a tamtzes, an essence, from your earlier work called the Taxe, the Taxe, zenen mirach deriber matineder. Therefore, we release you from your neder, mater neder, release from the neder. So you are released by publishing this work, the Klatsche. You are released from your earlier oath, haklatsche azu. And this is now in Lashon Kodesh. Haklatsche, I think it's Azu. And Mendele translates Hebrew Lashon Kodesh into Yiddish. Haklatsche Azu, di dozike klatsche, this klatsche, cheshuva lechem, is eich gerechend, will be counted for yourself, for you, will be considered for you. Keilu kaimesem, don't quote me on how to pronounce this. Gleich wir wollt gehalten wort und arroz gegeben achelik hasheini. Exactly like as if you kept your word and published a chelik hasheni, second chelik, second part, dem zweiten teil, second part, mehatakse, from the takse, bechol protiv, with all details, metali pichivkes, with all pichivkes. Pichivkes is little details. It's a funny word, but it means literally, pichivke is detail. Metali pichivkes, nishkushe, meken, mitir, zeir gut yoitze zain lechol ades. It's all right, very well. Meken mitir, one can, it is possible, with her, with this work, the klatche, her. Zeir gut yoitze zain lechol ades. Very well, satisfy your previous oath, lechol ades, in accordance with all understanding. Let me see. Deis, I think, is ideas or opinions. L'chola deis, it means by all means, something like that, in accordance with all opinions. Kama milas tovis lemokem. Wie viel Dank bin ich dem Obersten schuldig, wenn ich wohl der Tab die Klatsche glatt Gur und Geld vor euch, sie kaufen mir ein Pferdel, ist doch da jeno. Kama miles tovis lemokem. This is what we say during the Passover Haggadah. How many benefits do we owe to Lamakim? Lamakim is one of the words to describe Hashem. How much do we owe Hashem? How much do we owe Hashem for all the good things? Wie viel Dank bin ich dem Obersten schuldig? How many thanks am I obligated to give to the Obersten, the Almighty? Wenn ich wollt der Tab die Klatsche glatt Gur und Geld für euch. If I had gotten, if I, der Tappen is obtain. When I had obtained the klatsche simply without money in forest, ahead of time, because he was being paid in advance, without money in advance. Zu kaufen mir ein Pferdel, to buy myself a horse, ist doch dayeno, that would have been enough. If I were to just get the manuscript without an advance, a monetary advance, that would have been enough. Wenn ich wollte, now the word dayeno you will recognize because this is the song that we sing during the Pesach Dike Haggadah. And so Mendeley is using this language from the Haggadah, and we'll make some guesses as to why a little bit later. But it's interesting, and most readers will recognize that this language, Kama Milas Tovis Lamakim, and Dayeno. This language comes from Pesach. wenn ich wollt sie der Tat mit Geld vor euch, und sie wollt in sich nicht gehat a tamzes me ha taxe, is doch da jeno. And this is the style of the song Dayeno, and so Mendela continues in the same style. However, if I had received the klatche, if I had obtained the klatche with an advance, with a monetary advance, und nicht gehata und sie wollten sich nicht gehata tamzes mehatakse, is doch Dayeno. If the work, the klatche, did not have in itself an essence, a resemblance, literally, tamtzes is an essence from the klatche, is doch dayeno. Tamtzes is essence or gist or precis. Wenn sie wollten sich gehata tamzes mehatakse und die Dayonim wollten mir nicht gewähn materneder sein, ist doch Dayeno. Wenn die Dayonim wollten mir gewähn materneder sein und dabei sich nicht mehr schöne gekratzt, ist doch Dayeno. Let's translate. Well, if the klatsche had in itself an essence from the earlier work, the tax, and the rabbinical judges, Dayanim, wollt mir nicht materneder sein? Wollt mir nicht gewähn materneder sein? And the judges did not release me from my earlier oath. Is doch Dayeno. That would have been also enough. Wenn die Dayanim wollten mir gewähn materneder sein und dabei sich nicht mehr schon gekratzt, ist doch Dayeno. If the judges had released me from the earlier oath, but while doing the reading, while at it, dabei, sich nicht mehr schon gekratzt. They didn't start scratching themselves strangely from what, meaning from what's written there. The work is quite deep and strange work, and they started strangely scratching themselves because they couldn't quite figure out what's going on. Is doch Dayeno. Wenn sie wollten dabei sich mich schon gekratzt und ich wollte nicht gewusst, farwus, ist doch Dayeno. Wenn ich wollte gewusst, farwus und wollte nicht verstehen, als die Klatsche ist, apunim misugo, me soll von ihr kratzen, ist doch Dayeno. Let's translate. If they did scratch themselves strangely, and I didn't understand why. I didn't know why. For what reason? That would have been enough. If I did know why, farvus, and I didn't understand, und wollte nicht verstehen, as the klatsche is, apunim misugo, that the klatsche is apparently capable, misugal, capable, mezol von ihr kratzen. Klatsche is such a work that when you read it and you're a rabbinical judge, you will start thinking, what is this written here? And Mendele, as the publicist, as the publisher, understands exactly why they're scratching themselves. I mean, he knows what's going on inside them, what they must be thinking, or what is bothering them. Is doch Dayeno, that would have been enough. Al aches kama v'chama badafer dem oibersten danken, was ich hab der Tab de Klatsche und noch mit Geld für uns zu kaufen ein Pferdl und sie halt in sich a Tamzes mit a Taxe und die Dayonim haben mir Mater neder gewehen und sie haben dabei sich mir schon gekratzt und ich weiß für was und ich verstehe, als die Klatsche ist apunim mesogo, mir soll von ihr sich kratzen lechaper al kol avoinuseinu an upkumenish auf unsere Sind. Okay, this is quite a mouthful. Alachas kama v'chama. I think this means, and therefore. Badavich dem Oibirsten danken. I must praise the Almighty, the one above, thank rather, was a hob der tap de klatsche, that I received, that I obtained the klatsche, und noch mit geld for us, and in addition with an advance of money, zu kaufen a ferdel, to buy myself a horse. Und sie halten sich hatamtes mehr taxe. And this work, serendipitously, luckily for me, contains in itself an essence from my earlier work, the taxe. Und die Dayonim and the rabbinical judges ob mir mater neder gewein, and the Dayonim have released me from my earlier oath. Und sie ob derbei sich mischone gekratzt, and at the same time they started scratching themselves strangely. Und ich weiß warum, and I know why. Und ich verstehe, and I understand, as the klatsche is, and that this work, the klatsche, is apparently capable, mesugel, mezol funir sich kratzen, that when you read it, you will start scratching yourself to understand what's going on here, to figure out what's going on here. But Mendeleev knows why, what lies in, what kind of power this work has. Lechaper al kol avoyneseinu an upkumenish of unsere Sind. So this is in Lashon Kodesh, and this is in simple Yiddish. To be a kapora, to cover, to atone for all of our sins, an upkumenish is a kapora, something that takes on the suffering for on behalf of someone else. An upkumenish, a sufferer, the klatsche, both the nag, the little horse, and the work, is the sufferer of unsere Sind, for our sins. Odus raboisim bin ich oisim mit mein kurze hakdome. Vos of der lung, dus of der zung. Chav chei elul of der boid mit zforim, zwischen Lupsk und Teterivke, Hakotten, Mendele, Moichesforim. So here is what, my gentlemen, Odos Raboisim, Benechoisim, I am all about, I am concerned here with mit mein kurze Hakdama, with my brief introduction. Vus auf der Lung, dus auf der Zung. Whatever I had to say, I said it. I am not making any pretenses here. Nothing is hidden. Vus auf der Lung, dus auf der Zung. What I know, what I mean to say, I say it. Clear, crystal clear. Chav Ches Elul is the date in Elul. I think it's the 28th of the month of Elul in the summer. Of der Boyd mitzvorim, on top of a wagon loaded up with books, holy books, zwischen Glubsk und der Terivke, between on the road between the city of Glubsk and the shtetl, or the city of Teterivke, another shtetl, Hakotan, the small one or the insignificant one. Cotton means small. Mendele Moichesvarim, Mendele the book peddler, the bookseller. We just finished the introduction to the Kliatche. I wanted to talk very briefly about the last part where Mendele uses the style of the song Dayenu from Pesach, from Passover. And this is from the book Classic Yiddish Fiction. And the author here provides a translation, and you can read this translation in English. It's a very nice translation. And later, he provides his own understanding of why Mendele uses Dayenu to as part of his introduction. And what they say here is that his parody intimates that the corrupt leaders of the Jewish community are analogous to the Egyptians who had enslaved the ancient Hebrews. So I'm not sure if I would 100% agree with this, but perhaps this is one way to understand why Mendele is using this Dayenu. To me, this is more of a Thanksgiving style, a Thanksgiving manner that Mendele adopts, because in his introduction he says that whatever happened to him, he was in a really poor shape because his own horse died and he was stuck without any way to make money. And then suddenly somebody came up to him and said, "Would you like to buy a horse?" And when he started, what happened was that there was a horse presented as in a manuscript, and this manuscript not only provided him with money and not only with an advance before he had to do any work so that he could buy himself a horse, he was also released from the earlier oath. So he is very, very thankful to the Creator for giving him all these opportunities to make a living, to satisfy his earlier oath, and also to understand why the judges would be troubled by reading this work. So all in all, this is just a very lucky, serendipitous, like I said, occurrence for Mendele, and that's perhaps why he is using the style of the song Dayenu that we sing on Pesach.